All right, we are back. I'm gonna go ahead and take some of the advice I received in the forums and go ahead and just do the post-production on this particular deck and work on the new version of it. And then next week I'll go ahead and just start doing both the prefix and postfix on the same episode to kind of keep the confusion down a little bit. So so for this week we're just gonna have just this this to fix up, and then we'll get on track next week. Otherwise, if I begin a new one today, then we'll be messed up for a little bit longer. So I already have my my list that we're going to be changing this to done, but I wanted to go ahead and go through and point out some of the things that we kind of worked on while fixing the deck up. And I say we, but I mean me. And yes, I know that I have Ugin, can grab Worm Coil Engine. I quickly discovered that while building the while fixing the deck, but that doesn't warrant its inclusion in the deck at all, since it only reduces these two things, doesn't tap for mana, and paying 8 mana to get your Worm Coil Engine is not too valuable, since against like a deck like Mono Red or whatever, you're gonna want it earlier than that, and a deck like against like a deck like Control, you have time to find a Worm Coil Engine. You're not trying to find it with a land. So some of the things I definitely wanted to address is two Voltaic Keys seem like too much. I know it's good with Lux Cannon, but we have three Trinket Mage to grab it, and I just can't really imagine grabbing a second one of these too often. So we quickly cut that. The biggest problem that we were facing were like that I could at least imagine this deck facing are like the things like Mono Red, which we did have a little bit of trouble with. Granted, I played fairly poorly in the final game against that Mono Red player. Playing Tumble Magna on turn 3, for instance, was a mistake. And a couple other things, like not countering Burst Lightning. Just some stupid mistakes that I'm not sure why I made them. Maybe I was playing the deck for the first time or something. But I definitely made some mistakes that could have helped us out, although it still seemed like a bad matchup regardless. So some of the problems there is that our deck's a little slow, lacks spot removal, and some of our inherent synergies, like Lux Cannon and Voltaic Key, or Lux Cannon and Contagion Class, they just don't get online fast enough against them. Even Aulis Dust, it was okay in game 2, I believe, but besides that, it was, you know, it's a 7-mana sorcery, it's pretty lackluster. So I really wanted to address that with the changes, and I felt like the defining feature of this deck was not the fact that it was mono blue, but it was the fact that it was like a proliferate counter-based type of deck with Lux Cannons and Tumble Magnets. So I had no problem adding a second color to this list. Sometimes when I receive a list in the future, like a mono green list or something like that, and the deck is predominantly featured as a mono color deck for that reason, then I won't add any colors or anything like that if I can get away with it. But I think in this deck particularly, I don't think we hurt the mana any, and I think we add a lot of value for adding another color. So just to go over the things that I wanted to change, I definitely wanted the Voltaic Key gone. The Elixir was good in the mono-red matchup, but I don't really see grabbing it too often against anything else, so I wanted to move that to the board, so that freed up another slot as well. The Contagion Clasps, I originally wanted to add a third to, but it doesn't kill too much stuff in Standard. It kills like a Lotus Cobra or Birds of Paradise or, you know, random Steplings sometimes, stuff like that, but I couldn't justify adding another one of those to the deck. The All's Dust I decided to cut. I decided to cut just the entire Eldrazi package because we're going to add an additional color for removal, so there's really no reason to keep the All's Dust around. It's okay against Planeswalkers, but we already have Lux Cannon to deal with Planeswalkers pretty handedly. So I wouldn't do that. And then I think I ended up cutting one Tumble Magnet. I'm not sure. We'll see the finished list in a second. Tumble Magnet was good. I might have left off 4, I'm not sure. It's good, but we added spot removal in other forms, so I felt okay with cutting it. Also, I changed up the mana base a lot. We're going to end up adding black. You'll see what we do to it. We don't really make this a blue-black control list like the typical Mimic Vat or anything like that, but I just wanted some black for spot removal and things like that. Out of the sideboard, some things I didn't like. His Contagion Engine, I just felt like it was never going to be good against basically anything, so I cut that quickly. The All's Dust went just as quickly as these ones did, since we're not going to have any synergies with them. Into the Royal, I didn't really like in the board. Like, if you're going to run Into the Royal, I think you want in the main deck. So I went ahead and cut those. Necropedes were in the list for a very long time. At one point, I even had Trinket Mage to grab Block Lifestaff out of the sideboard to put on, we went up to 4 Necropedes and the Trinkomages, and you could throw a Sobok Lifestaff on these guys and just gain life and kill mono red players pretty easily. But once we had another color, they basically just became outclassed. There was just better options in Necropede. So while Necropede is quite good in the monocolor version of this deck, I don't think it's needed outside of that. Flash Freeze, I like a lot. It wasn't valuable in any of the matches we played before, but I wanted to go ahead and take the Spell Pierce and make it a fourth Flash Freeze, so I think I ended up doing that. And then this Contagion Clasp, again, there's not too many decks where, like, the first clasps are even good, so bringing a third is not too valuable. There's no Mythic deck, for instance, and Cunning Spark Mages aren't seeing a lot of play in the main deck, and just things like that, so it really wasn't valuable. So I went ahead and just cut all this stuff. Of course, the mana base got changed as well. I wanted to keep the 4 Tectonic Edge just because they offer a lot of value against man lands. And I wanted to keep these Everflowing Chalices as well. I actually thought about adding a fourth, as you'll see shortly, but I couldn't really justify it since we were cutting all his dust. But at the same time, I didn't want to cut any of them because we have so many valuable 4 drops to get on turn 3 that it was a pretty big deal. Mystifying Maze, while good, it had to be cut just for the fact that it does not produce 2 colors of mana or kill a land or something like that. So I went ahead and cut that. Eye of Ugin is, of course, gone, as are the Eldrazi Temples. All factors in the fact that we're going to add a second color and we're cutting all assist. So I'm going to load up the other deck really quickly, and we'll be back and see what the new deck looks like. Alright, so here we have the updated list. Still want to pay attention to some things while we play. We don't want to just, you know, of course, write this off as, like, the best deck, so or the best version of the deck. So as we play and afterwards, we'll, of course, any of the changes we made, we can comment on afterwards if something seemed a little subpar or whatever. I'm not going to do another video for it, of course, but at the same time, like, it'll help to... I don't know what just happened. It'll help to kind of lay out the ideas for the deck even further for anyone that wants to take the deck and mess with it even more. But basically, we made it into a blue-black list. The only black additions to the main deck are basically Creeping Tar Pits, which are pretty key at killing Planeswalkers, and they help with due to the loss of Olive's Dust. We still have Lux Cannon, of course, deal with Planeswalkers as well, but Creeping Tar Pits are nice. They actually give us a little bit of reach that we didn't have before. Before, we only had Wormcoil Engines and Trinket Mage to win with, and then Jace, of course. But Creeping Tar Pit gives you even that little extra. Doomblades are going to be key, I think, for dealing with the larger creatures out of the ramp decks, like the Titans and things like that, that Lux Cannon's a little slow to, but it's also good at, you know, helping against Mono Red and Boros and White Weenie and those just quick aggressive decks. So we went ahead and added 4 of those. Those are really the only black additions to the main deck. We picked up some nice black cards for the sideboard as well, but we ended up with 11 sources of black in the main. 4 Tar Pits are pretty key. 3 Catacombs, 3 Dark Slick Shores, and 1 Swamp. Swamp's not really, like, it could be easily be a Catacomb or a Dark Slick Shore, but I just wanted to have another land that pretty much always comes into play untapped, because we already have 10 that could come into play tapped, 4 of them always come into play tapped, and then the other 6 occasionally will come into play tapped. So I went ahead with 1 Swamp. I don't think it hurts the deck much, because you still have 9 islands along with 10 additional sources. So you have 19 blue sources, which is actually more than the original list even had. We kept the 4 Tectonic Edges, kept 3 Everflowing Chalice. I thought about adding 1 Jace Beller into this deck, but we already have 7 3 drops that we kind of want to play on turn 3. And with the 3 Everflowing Chalice, I think this Jace is just as good, if not better, because you get so much more versatility out of him. But 1 Jace Beleren could be used in this deck. It's all a little bit of preference there. As far as the sideboard, we picked up a couple Memoricides for the ramp decks. Before, we really didn't have much against ramp decks. We had some counter spells, but the problem with that is if they summoning trap you, you just die. We kept to the 2 negates. We went to 4 Flash Freeze, which is good against mono red or the ramp decks or, you know, anything like that. 3 Disfigures. These kind of replaced the Necropedes from the former list. They're a little bit faster. They're a little bit better against ramp because you can kill Lotus Cobras and Oracle Moldiahs proactively, whereas Necropede could never really do that because it's not going to attack into you. So I think these will be a nice addition. I almost added 4, but I wanted to get the 1 Nihil Spellbomb in here just to help out against Vengevine decks and Pyromancer Ascension. But if those aren't big in your metagame, you could easily go up to 4 Disfigures. 2 Consume the Meeks kind of replaced our All's Dust. Much better against Mono Red, much better against Boros, much better against Elves. Pretty much, you know, just a quick quick wrath effect. We only have 11 black sources, but between the 4 preordains, the 4 jaces, we should be able to get there fairly easily. And if not, we can definitely tweak that at a later date, like switch one more island to a another Drowned Catacombs or something. But so that's something to keep in mind while we play this, is to see if we can cast Consuming Week pretty easily. We moved our Elixir to the board, so we're going to bring this in against Mono Red. And then, like I said, the Spell Bomb is the only other addition. If you have a lot of aggro in your metagame, you might want to go up to 4 Disfigure. But I think 3 will be fine. That gives us Brittle Effigy, 4 Preordain, 3 Disfigure, and Voltaic Key as turn 1 plays. And then Elixir too, I guess, and usually in those matchups. And then Consumed Meek can clear up anything we don't take care of with our Contagion Clasps or Disfigure or Doomblade. So this is the new list. The deck didn't get much more expensive. Actually, it probably got cheaper. Because while we did add this mana base, which is, you know, I don't know, on Moto, they're probably a couple tickets each. We took out All's Dust, which are pretty expensive. Eldrazi Temples are pretty expensive. Ive Ugin is a little expensive. Mystifying Maze is probably only a ticket or so. And then we really just added some commons. And then a couple of cheap rares. I don't play much Moto or buy anything on Moto, so I don't know exactly how much these are, but they can't be more than like a couple tickets each. So we probably kept the deck roughly the same price, maybe even a little bit cheaper. I'm not usually going to be worrying about if a deck is budget or not. It's not really my thing. I think that, you know, if you're playing a deck, you should be able to put the resources in it to make it the best deck regardless of price or anything like that. It doesn't necessarily mean you have to go out and buy all the cards. You can trade for them or win them or, you know, whatever. But I don't feel that you... That sometimes I don't feel like you give yourself the best chance of winning if you're going to set limitations for yourself. So so that is one thing with the emails that, like, ask a deck to stay budget or request not to add Jaces or something like that. Like, I'm basically not going to work on those decks in a public manner just because, I don't know, I feel like it's you're shorting yourself, and eventually you have to get over that hump anyway and invest just to play the best deck. I've never been much in the way of... advocating for budget strategies. Even when I was dirt poor, I would do everything I could to win drafts and, you know, take the best rare every time, or trade for them or borrow cards or whatever. There's always a way to acquire cards, and so I'm definitely not going to keep that like as a focus when I'm doing these fixes. But I thought it was worth mentioning here at least that, you know, we didn't really make the deck too much more expensive. That said, we're gonna fire up a daily event and play all 4 rounds and see how this does. Again, we still want to keep our eye on the deck and make sure it's functioning properly. Just because we change it doesn't mean it's perfect by any means. So we back for the first round of this daily.